said they're moving to LA. Not a soul I know around, but everybody's leaving town. Some caught a freight, some caught a plane. And the sunshine needs the rain. Like to try and settle down, but everybody's leaving town. Some go to win, some go to lose. The time Charlie's got the blues. You know my heart keeps telling me you ain't a kid at 43. Play around, you lose your wife. Play too long, you lose your life.
My name is Tony Griffin, and this is Dave Zeleznik on the banjo here. Give him a hand, would you please? Banjo players don't get much recognition. There's probably a reason for that, but not in his case. He's from Bridgeport. Here's something from the Stones.
Childhood death. Slap.
one song here that I wrote, and I have a very, selfish motive for playing it for you. I want you to buy an album, which happens to be over to my left here. I brought four of them along, the last of a collection of 7,000. So you're welcome to buy one if you like. This is the title song from the album. Oh, that's good. Three of us, and we're taking it kind of slow to see what everybody knows and can do and so on, but this is Mara Beckerman up here. She's from New York City, and top flight actress, who was nominated for a Tony a few years ago, didn't get it, that's why she's working with us. What was the name of that play you were in again?
Charlotte Sweet, keep your eyes open for it.
Then we're going to warm her up here with a tune from John Prine here. Wait a minute, folks, we're out of tune here. Is that you or me? Excuse us, John. Make me an angel, a thousand of Montgomery. Make me a poster for a rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. Believe it, this river. I'm a young man, and after my father, my mother's another child that's grown old. Dreams of thunder, lightning was desire, the soul house was burnt down a long time ago. Make me an angel, a thousand Montgomery. Make me a poster for a rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. Believe in this living is a heart. down
a long time ago. Make me an angel, a thousand mark offer. Make me a poster, an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. And even this is a hard way to go.
Share the banjo on it.
I can hear him buzzing. I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person go to work in the morning, come home in the evening, and have nothing to say? Make me an angel, a thousand Montgomery. Make me a poster.
Dave's going to take a minute there to tune. We need to read a couple of commercials here and thank some of the people who've made our appearance here today possible. Are you looking for a different kind of vacation this year? Or are you tired of being jostled by ill-mannered and boorish crowds at the tired-out spas of Cannes and Florence? Yeah? Well, Mayhem Travel has something special for you. Since 1984, Mayhem Travel has catered to the experienced vacationer by offering once-in-a-lifetime tours to today's trouble spots. On our Cedars of Lebanon tour, for example, you'll stay at the blood-racing Druze Militia Hilton, where you and your thrill-seeking companions can experience the heart-stopping excitement of nearby artillery barrages and factional strife. You'll start your day in the once sumptuous remains of the hotel dining room with breakfast served by Ahmed, Mahmoud, and Ali, real-life Druze warriors acting as your personal escorts in this vacation with a difference. Next, you'll be whisked by captured armored Syrian personnel carrier to a hotly contested neighborhood where you can get a first-hand view of the action. For dinner, you'll enjoy the quick repartee of the battle-hardened crew of an Israeli gunboat, then to the airport for a quick and relaxing flight to your next trouble spot, the Syrian frontier with Iran. So, before you plan your next vacation, think Mayhem. Mayhem Travel, that is, in New Canaan, Greenwich, Westport, and Fairfield. We'd like to be your guides for that vacation with a difference. Thank you. We put a little bit different arrangement to it. See if we can get through it in tune here. Of the you haven't received an official invitation, let me be the first one to invite you to use the portalettes out back. What's next? Oh yeah, we're doing a song here called Old Train. And Mara takes the lead on. I'm gonna try and back her up on it. This is a bluegrass song from the Seldom Seen. Stuff and right now we're in a bluegrass mood, so we're gonna keep it up as long as we can remember this. You ready for this? Okay.
Yeah.
Why don't you say something about this song? If you know anything, do you know anything about this song?
I know anything. It's either Bill Monroe or Jimmy Martin. It's called Chalk Up Another One, and it's about all I'm gonna say, and I think it speaks for itself.
Broken heart, for every life you ruined, 'cause you and your soul.
That's Mara Beckerman. Maybe we can get her back here before we leave the stage. Thank you, Mara. I'm going to change the pace a little bit and play a song written by a songwriter named Billy Ed Wheeler. This is called Cold Tattoo. Thank you.
Somebody day. We sure believe a little good news today. We sure believe a little good news today.
Thank you. Do a song here that Nat King Cole made famous.
Riders in the sky. Baggers in the sky. Riders in the sky.
Thank you. You get that thing fixed? One more time on what? On him? You're pointing to go off the stage. You want us to go off? Key of G. We've been together for years. This is a song written by a fellow by the name of, I think it was Guy Clark. Didn't he write this one? Who's an alcoholic songwriter in Nashville. And he's had a couple of hits, and he's written for Ricky Skaggs and some other people. And this is, I think, one of his better efforts. I don't know if that's been by Guy Clark or not. I might be wrong, but who cares? We're going to play it anyway. It's called Old Chunk of Coal. See you again sometime soon, someplace else, in the great festival beyond the sky.
He got a custom compliment. He got an Eldorado too. He got a 32 gun in his pocket.
looks so nice. Boy, he had his hands eyes upon her. Then the trouble soon began. And the hero went round, he learned a lesson about master with the wife of a jealous man. Oh, he bad. Roy Brown, baddest man in the whole damn.